Module 186. This module is related with the globalization and the China. Here we need to understand how China has received a lot of benefits through the process of globalization and how it is going to create influence through the globalization across the world as well. So, first thing is that whenever we are try to understand the age of globalization for the Chinese perspective, initially we have observed that China generally opposed the process of globalization and specifically global political order, because China basically believed on insurgencies across other countries, and so they don't believe on the globalization process or this global political order. And secondly, they were not in favor of global institutions just like the IMF and the World Bank. However, during 1966 to 1976, different kind of, first the Cultural Revolution has occurred, because previous to that, China has passed through the process of different kind of regimes, in which just like over the two centuries, actually this process has evolved. The system were tested and they were found unsuccessful, including socialism. Socialism was applied, and that was not so much successful. Then capitalism was tried, and that was not found more effective. Then the empire system was established. Then the republic system was established. Warlords were ruled, or even the religious fundamentalists. So that was the scenario over the previous two centuries, which has make it clear that different kind of system which were applied and tested, they are not suitable for Chinese economy in terms of its growth and prosperity. However, China is found that kind of region after specifically this Cultural Revolution, which has been done under Mao Zedong, in which China's growth, overall growth happens and became more stable. And secondly, China's growth leads to create prosperity in the region as well. Otherwise, previously it was expected by other countries, the regional countries or the neighboring countries, that once the China is going to flourish, then it will definitely capture the greatest market share across the world, and so the neighboring country could not get that kind of share. That share is going to be redistributed, and China will capture the whole market share belonging to that particular region. But generally, what happens is totally opposite. Prosperity of China leads to the prosperity of the region. So China ultimately eliminate this sponsoring to the insurgencies in other regions, as well as start honoring the international global institution, just like IMF, World Bank, World Trade Organization, and even got the membership of that. So ultimately, it start globalizing itself. So this process, actually, you can understand through this graph or diagram here, how Chinese GDP has grown over the time. If we try to understand this, this data shows from 1950 to 78 time period. And then this data shows from 1979 to 2018, the most recent trend. If we observe that the China and Japan, the Japan's growth or GDP growth was remarkably excellent, growing so much high and increasing much more. On the other side, the growth prospects of Chinese near about remain slow, very slow, and the gap between two has grown up. So that was the scenario. But after 1979, if we observe, on average, the growth rate mostly remain higher than 8%. So if we observe this line, most of the time, unless this this era as well as close to this era, the growth rate a bit reduced or diminishes. Otherwise, it actually remains quite high. So it shows that the process of globalization allowed Chinese economy to stabilize as well as grow rapidly, or stably, with stability at higher growth rate. Further, if we observe the US and Chinese annual GDP growth rates in 2010 to 18, it is quite visible that China's growth rate previously quite high, but over the time it is going to decline. So what is expected that actually the US growth rate, which is a bit lower, that is going to be catch up, or you can say the US is going to catch the Chinese growth rate, or both are going to be the same after this time period, close to 2034 and onward. And afterward, it is expected that US growth rate would be a bit higher than the Chinese growth rate. Secondly, if we observe the Chinese GDP based on purchasing power parity and share in global trade, in terms of percentage, how much US and Chinese GDP as compared to share of GDP global share of global total, mean to say how much global output is there and what is their proportional contribution in that, then US contribution is declining, but the Chinese contribution is rising. And that has happened in the time period of 2012 to 2014. In between, this catch-up has appeared. So actually, China is growing, performing much better than US through the process of globalization.